Luke chapter 21, beginning of verse 29, says this. Jesus told them all this parable. Look at the fig tree, he says, and all the trees. When they sprout leaves, you can see for yourselves and know that summer is near. He's talking about signs, right? He's talking about witnessing visible things that tell us what's coming. So, I mean, right now, this time of year, let's be honest. You look out the window and you can see things starting to sprout and grow, leaves coming back on trees that lost their leaves. You see pollen beginning to float. And all I can say is, oh man, I know allergy season is coming. I can feel it in my nose and my eyes. I can feel it all the way back in my sinus and my head. I got to start taking that Zyrtec again. I don't know if you take allergy medicine, but I've found that if I don't take it, oh, I'm miserable, right? I feel like I've got a cold for 3 months. So the signs are coming, right? Spring is here. The days are getting longer. It's warming up. It's beautiful. You want to hang outside more. But here Jesus is giving some signs. And he's saying, hey, you know that summer is coming. You know that summer is near when you can see these things taking place. But this is what he goes on to say. Even so, when you see these things happening, you'll know that the kingdom of God is near. Truly, I tell you, this generation will certainly not pass away until all these things have happened. Heaven and earth will pass away, he says, but my words will never pass away. Be careful, or your hearts will be weighed down with carousing and drunkenness and the anxieties of life, and that day will close on you suddenly like a trap. For it will come on those who live on the face of the whole earth. Be always on the watch and pray that you may be able to escape so that all that is about to happen and that you may be able to stand before the Son of Man. Each day Jesus was teaching in the temple, and each evening he went out to spend the night on the hill called the Mount of Olives. All the people came early in the morning to hear him at the temple. So Jesus is referring to the passage just previous to this. He was giving a whole long list and teaching on the signs that will come at the end of the age. What he's trying to remind the people is, man, watch for it. You can see it coming. You know it's happening, just like us now. We see the signs around us, right? We see the chaos in the world around us. We see the fear of those who live in this world and who are overcome by the world. We see them consumed even with hatred and disdain for one another. We see it in politics, and we see it on the news, and we see it all over the place, the signs, right? But what Jesus is saying here, something that he wants us to understand, is he wants us to learn a different way of looking at the world. He wants us to have a shift in our perspective. I think he wants us to have a right now, forever perspective. Here's what that means. It's about finding balance in the way we look at everything. You've seen the signs. You know what's going on around you, the chaos and confusion, the fear and all the things people are dealing with. You know his kingdom is coming. So live like it's coming today. Live like today is your last day on earth. Live a life of faith and truth and hope. Don't hold back on telling someone the good news or doing something you know you need to do. But at the same time, you got to find that right now perspective, that forever perspective. At the same time, we got to find balance, like by living like he's not going to come for another 100 years or 1,000 years. We live a life that plans ahead, a life that finds balance, but at the same time, we live our lives here and now in the world today full of faith and hope and love. We don't get consumed by the worries and the concerns of everyone else, no matter what signs we see, because he's reigning in our hearts. See you next time.